está cansado de la economía de su país, ya no puede mantener a su familia, tiene sus pobres niños corriendo por las calles pidiendo dinero o vendiendo chicles, ya no tiene que preocuparse por eso. Ahora la nueva agencia de servicio de inmigración, 1-800-666-BRUJO, una ramificación más de brujería, le ofrece los siguientes servicios. Puede usted pasar a Estados Unidos con muy poco dinero. Les ofrecemos, con nuestra más grande experiencia,
choferes con experiencia, drogas seguras, no más que 20 a la vez.
Y le aseguramos que no va a tener ningún problema en su trabajo. Le ofrecemos números de seguro buenos, tarjetas de inmigración o la tarjeta verde que se le llama, también muy buena. Y hasta incluso le damos como un bono extra, una licencia totalmente legal. Así es que ya sabe, nuestro lema es...
¿Pasas o no pagas?
Así es, 1-800-666-BRUJO.
Y acuérdate, la migra, no.
We admit that some of the upcoming images are very strong, but what has happened in Houston, leaving a sequence of deaths and horror, cannot be overlooked. This summer, two Hispanics, Mario Rios and Alma Rios, disappeared as if they were swallowed by the earth. When their bodies were found, dismembered, the police refused to give out any information, and the whole world asked, what happened to them? We explain it in this chronicle of Satanism, rock, and assassination. Mario Rios and his partner Alma Rios were last seen alive the morning of June 28th of this year. 4 days later, the dismembered and headless bodies were found in plastic bags just south of Rosenberg, Texas, near the city of Houston. The authorities originally linked a series of pictures where several youths appear with band logos of heavy rock music in Spanish, but the picture that caught the investigators' attention was the one of a man holding a severed human head, from which the detectives assumed that it could be the head of Mario Rios. The assumption quickly changed when we found out the picture was an album cover of a band called Brujeria. Now the detectives are trying to determine the connection with this type of music and the macabre murder. The detective also says that they will have to investigate the beliefs of Mario Rios, who was known to have practiced Santeria. What has disturbed the authorities the most is the connection of the youth in the photos and Spanish satanic music. This record or cassette are not hard to find, and you can buy them at your local record store. Black masses, killing white boys, molesting dead children are just some of the titles of the band Brujeria, which talk about murder and sexual relationship with the cadavers of dead children. The covers of this record are not far behind, with pictures of mutilated bodies and diabolical figures. Without a doubt, some of these records tell the buyer of this content and come with a strong warning. One way to see the relationship of Spanish satanic music and the murder of Mario Rios and Alma Rios and the influence this music has over young kids. Because they glorify it, they make it look like it's something good, something normal. That's why the kids of today are the way they are, because they have a lot of this crap within their reach to see and listen to, and I think they should not sell this stuff, and it should be banned because of this crap they sell in this store. Be one of this case. Do you know what type of music your kids are listening to?
In Houston, Texas, Cristina Garza, para Ocurrió Así.
Yes, do you know the type of music your kids are listening to? In this case, we just presented to you the heads of the two people who disappeared have not been found. The families of the victims refuse to talk because they are afraid. We are trying to talk to somebody responsible for the group Brujeria, and at this point, we have not been able to get anyone to accept our invitation. So the investigation continues.